It got so quiet here right now.
Let's go, Chad.
Good?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, and thank you for coming to the Ritz-Carlton here in Los Angeles, but it's a great view and an appropriate place to make a great announcement. You know, a year and a half ago, DAZN and Matchroom made an announcement about a $1 billion commitment to bring excellence and great matches and great events to the world of boxing. And I think you can tell by the sign in front of this podium and the wall behind me that that commitment to fight fans is going to continue, as on February 29th, it's going to be a great night of boxing and a great matchup. So here to tell you more about it is the man behind Matchroom Boxing USA and Matchroom itself, Mr. Eddie Hearn.
Thank you, Michael, and thank you, everybody, for being in attendance today here in Los Angeles for what is a very important announcement to cap what has been a wonderful year for DAZN, for Matchroom Boxing USA. Of course, we're here to formally announce the fight on February the 29th in Frisco, Texas, at the Dallas Cowboys Sports Center. Thank you to Jerry Jones for chasing this fight down between four-division world champion Mikey Garcia and two-division world champion Jessie Vargas. It's Guerrero v. Guerrero. It's a great fight. And talking to Jesse on the way here, we're still the shades of Guerrero against Morales here in an all-action Mexican fight that I think he's going to light up the fans in Texas and also light on DAZN. It's been, as I said, an amazing year or so on the DAZN platform. I feel particularly the last few months have been outstanding. And when we look back on the year at what we've achieved from a standing start, I think he's been sensational, particularly the last 7 or 8 weeks, of course, with Canelo Kovalev, and in before that, Golovkin against Derevchenko fight of the year. And we saw Inoue against Dener, we saw Josh Taylor against Regis Progress, all fight of the year contenders. We moved to that crazy event just across the road with Logan Paul against KSI, which broke broadcast records around the world. And in Saudi Arabia, just over a week ago, we saw Anthony Joshua reclaiming the world heavyweight titles in Saudi Arabia against Andy Ruiz on a great night of boxing after that epic evening on June the 1st at Madison Square Garden. It's been a memorable year with so many great nights, and just 2 days away we have Danny Jacobs fighting Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. in front of what will be over 10,000 in Phoenix, Arizona to cap what has been a marvelous year. And I'm very proud to stand here today, not just after the year, but stand next to these two gentlemen, because both have come to us during different times and different periods. And for Mikey Garcia, I think a year and a half of trying to get this young man with Matchroom Boxing USA and DAZN. And we had our first meeting, I believe it was at the Sheraton, at LAX. I was a little bit nervous, I sat down with him, and as a fight fan, this is a guy that I've watched for years and years, four division world champion. I told him that we had a plan, we had a dream to reignite the sport of boxing in America with Matchroom Boxing USA. And there was this new platform called DAZN. It was a streaming service. It was going to disrupt the pay-per-view model. And I felt like I gave it a great pitch. But I did look at him and he was like, I want to just see how this goes. And every time we had a significant movement, every time we had a significant fight or a significant signing, I would text Mikey. I would have another meeting with Mikey Garcia. Canelo Alvarez signed, Triple G signed, Anthony Joshua signed, Usyk signed, Billy Joe Saunders signed, Danny Jacobs signed, Demetrius Andre signed, Tevin Farmer signed. And it was just the momentum there that got me the opportunity to sit in front of this great fighter again. And we're delighted to be working with him moving forward, starting February the 29th, as I said. This man was one of the first guys that jumped ship. And actually, ironically, when we sat down for our conversation, the fight that I most wanted to make was Mikey Garcia against Jesse Vargas. And Jesse Vargas put a lot of faith into us. He's had two great fights with Thomas Delorme and Humberto Sosa, and I'm really pleased that he gets this opportunity as well to have this big standout fight. Like I said, four division world champion, two division world champion, brilliant fighters, and a fight that can only go one way, which is one of pure excitement. And we want to thank both guys for accepting this challenge. It will be a great night on February 29th. Before we hear from the fighters and some of their teams as well, I want to ask to come up a young man who has found out what the sport of boxing can do to you. This man looked at least 15 years younger at the launch of the Zone. He's learned so much about the sport of boxing, the ups, the downs, the frustrations, the arguments, but the excitement and the reason that we love this sport so much. Ladies and gentlemen, the Vice President of the Zone, Joe Marcassi.
Thanks, Elie. Less said about our arguments, the better in front of the media. But listen, I'd like to echo your comments, not only welcoming Mikey Garcia to the Zone family, the Zone team, but my excitement for the entire Garcia-Vargas event. You've heard me, you've heard Elie, you've heard our marketing, more importantly, talk a lot about fight season on the Zone over the last couple of months. And Mikey Garcia-Jessie Vargas from Texas on February 29th will be the official start to our second fight season at the end of February 2020. So Mikey, welcome to the Zone formally. I can remember, as Elie mentioned, being in meetings more than sort of 18 months ago talking about our plans in the US and talking about how you're exactly the kind of fighter that we wanted to bring onto the service. Fierce competitor, a fan base that turns up in the arena and on broadcast, and obviously an appealing fight style. So we're delighted to welcome you formally to the family. It's a privilege to be working with everyone on stage today. We are obviously committed financially and from a marketing perspective to delivering a first-class experience for our fan base. We've put together the best roster in the sport of boxing. Some of the names Elie mentioned, Canelo Alvarez, Anthony Joshua, Triple G. And we're so glad to add another Garcia to that roster. And we hope that it can stay there for many years to come. Jesse, what can I say? Probably my first friend in the sport of boxing after the man behind you. You believed in our vision from day one. You were at our launch event in New York last July. And you headlined our first show in October in Chicago. Not only from a fighter perspective, you provided expert analysis on all of our broadcasts. You taught people in both English and in Spanish how to say the Zone, how to pronounce the brands. You've commentated on our shows. We're truly appreciative of everything you do to support our service. So thank you. We're so happy that you're kicking off our second fight season. But to all of you in the media, thank you for coming today. Hope you're all headed back to your cars. Maybe some of you invited on Elie's plane. I saw on Instagram this morning, down to Phoenix for our final show of the year. Jacob Chavez, sure to be a fantastic event. We look forward to seeing you all in the new year. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Joe. We're just going to call up now a guy who seems to be representing virtually every fighter in boxing right now in Guadalupe, Valencia. Guadalupe was one of the first guys that we spoke to. He put the deal together for Jesse Vargas to join Matchroom and wants to say a few words about this particular fight that's been talked about for a while. Ladies and gentlemen, the lawyer for Jesse Vargas, Guadalupe Valencia.
I want to thank everybody. This is a fight that I've literally been thinking about and talking about for about a year and a half. About a year and a half ago, I talked to Robert Garcia, Mikey's brother, and I told him, you know, I was representing Jesse, and I said, wow, don't you think this would be a great fight? And the reason I thought back then and the reason I think now this is a great fight, you have, like they said earlier, you got a four-division world champion in Mikey who's fought a lot of great fighters, a lot of great fights, has a big fan base, he's in the prime of his career, and he's not afraid of anybody, and he's just a strategist, he's a brawler, there's all these great things to say about him. And then in Jesse Vargas, we have a two-division world champion, he's a technician, he's got a big fan base, he's fought all the top fighters in the world. You know, when Saddam Ali was in his prime, he knocked him out, nobody thought that was gonna happen. He fought Timothy Bradley, he fought Manny Pacquiao, he fought Delorme, he's fought a lot of great fighters, so, and Jesse's in his prime. And so really, you have all the ingredients of a great fight. Two Mexican-Americans who are in the prime of their life, I think we have all the ingredients of a great fight. And so I've been pushing for this fight for a long time. When I learned that Elie was in talks with Mikey, I told him, you know, this is the fight I'd love to see, and finally it's happened. And I think that the biggest prize for everybody, I think, is the fans, because I don't think that this is going to be just a normal fight. I think this is going to be a great fight. And people mentioned rivalries. This is not a rivalry because there's no antagonism between the two, but they're two great fighters matched together. And once, you know, the bell rings, everything is out the door, and each person's going to try to win this fight. So I think the fans are going to be the recipients of an amazing fight, an amazing event. And I want to also thank everybody who helped put this together. Al Hagen's one of the advisors for Jesse. He really liked the fight also. We talked about the fight. Eddie believes in this fight, and so I want to thank everybody who had something to do with this fight. And we'll see you guys all in Texas soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Lupe. We're going to bring up one half of this great fight. As I said, one of the first guys that believed in us.